Hi, I'm Dr. Steve Augustine from the Action Sports Medicine Foundation. We just finished up our third Dinner with the Supercross Stars event, which is a fundraiser for our foundation. It's something that we do every year here in conjunction with the Jacksonville Supercross. What we're doing with the foundation is raising money so that we can continue the program, grow it, build it, and hopefully make it a very solid thing in the future. What we're going to do is hopefully provide athletic trainers at the event, as well as doctors, and then bring our on-site medical unit, which is a motorhome that we've kind of converted and made it an ER on wheels. We're able to reduce fractures, reduce dislocations, put people in splints, evaluate them, basically save them a trip to the ER. Obviously, there's some things that still need to go to the emergency room, and we'll send those out. But in general, we're able to take care of probably 80% of the injuries that occur at events.
In action sports, you're always going to get hurt. I mean, that's kind of just the nature of the beast, but we all love what we do, and we take as good a precautionary measures as we can to keep it on two wheels or whatever, but unfortunately, injury hurts, and whenever it happens, it's good to have a good team behind you, and that's what these guys are doing.
Here we are in Jacksonville. We're really excited to be here tonight. A great occasion for all of us to get dressed up, come out, and then support such a good cause at the ASMF. We've been fortunate enough to be invited to this, and it's a great cause. Ralph, you get to dress up tonight, too.
Well, actually, one of us got dressed up. The other two pretty much just dug up whatever we had left laying around in the suitcase. And this is a great event. I guess three of us have been here last handful of years, and it grows and grows and grows every year. It's a fantastic night in Jacksonville. It's one of the highlights, I think, of the Supercross season, and it's great to come out and support ASMF.
Without Dr. Augustine and those guys supplying this medical help, accidents at the track would definitely be a lot worse than they really need to be.
How many times have you moms and dads or families, people that are here, or riders, been injured at an amateur race and have, an EMT or somebody just cart you off in a pickup truck and drag you off the track?
My worst injury would have to be an injury that I got in 1998. I crashed and broke my tibula, and it required surgery and getting home from like 16 hours north in a car, and I didn't want to have surgery in the place that it was. I wanted to get home, so I was 16 and hurting, and just me and my dad, so it was an injury that I'll never forget.
My worst injury was probably when I didn't even crash and I tore my ACL. That one was a tough one to come back from. A lot of rehab and a lot of willpower.
I think my worst injury came in 2002 in Atlanta. I broke my right femur, and it kept me out of racing for like 6 months. Probably one of the gnarliest crashes and the most pain I've been in.
I've had many injuries myself. Probably one of my worst is I had a blown out left knee. I needed full reconstruction.
My worst injury was probably last year. I broke my tib and fib pretty badly, and that was a pretty bad one. I've had a lot of other ones, but that was probably the worst.
We try and spread ourselves as far as we can, and obviously what we do just depends on our budget, and this is why we have fundraisers like this. We try and get sponsors on board so that we can continue the program and get out there and cover more and more events and spread the word and make it so that action sports athletes have that same level of medical care that other athletes have. You go out to a college football game, there's 5-6 trainers there, there's doctors, and I want to have that same level of care for the action sports athletes that are out there. In our regional events, we covered 50 of those last year. We treated over 1,600 athletes. So basically, just last year, we provided care for over 2,500 athletes. And the thing is it's free.
There's no charge to the athletes, and that's the beauty of the program, is it's free to the athletes, and that's the way we want to run this program, giving back to the sports that we love.
He's not making money on this. He's helping people. Thank you very much.
You know, I broke my tib and fib in my left leg 3 years ago, and came straight to Dr. Augustine and had him fix it, and got back probably sooner than most people would with the same injury. So
my name is Irv Braun, and this, of course, is
Ashley Phillips.
And we're here with the Action Sports Medicine Foundation. This is the night with the Supercross Stars, and we were overwhelmed with about 15 different riders, and it was probably the best time. This is our third annual, but Actually, I'd have to say it knocked the socks off. It was awesome.
It did indeed. This is my first annual, actually, to come, but I will be back next year. It was a huge rider turnout, so much support. We auctioned off jerseys live this year, which was just amazing.
This is going to be a collector's item. This number is probably going to change. So we get 200, 200 up here. How about $300? $350, you bought it, sir. Justin Barcia, you get the whole outfit.
Jeff, do you have anything out there that's being auctioned, or is there anything that you're putting your money on?
No, my stuff is way too old. It's already, you know, it's too fragile. It falls apart. But there's all kinds of great stuff here.
Miss Ashley Filett back there. We're going to start. Yeah. Yeah. I started many, many years ago as a youngster on minis and has became a well-known fast lady around our planet. So do I hear $75? Andrew Short right there. $100. $100 over here, $150.
What's so nice about this foundation is that they bring the support to the riders, and that's really what it's about, is the awareness of injuries and injury prevention, really, because it is such a dangerous sport, and they go into action sports. They're in wakeboarding, surfing, all kinds of stuff. So it's a great foundation, and we're just happy to be here.
We're trying to get more involved and create a certification across the country for paramedics so that they're familiar with action sports, motocross, BMX, skateboarding, all of those sports, and how it's a little different in taking care of those athletes and their injuries versus your traditional stick and ball sports.
This is one of the research projects we did. We looked at injuries that occurred between supercross and motocross through 2001 to 2006. And this information is important. You can take this information. It allows us to look at these athletes and say, hey, these are the type of injuries that we're seeing. We have a big association with Road to Recovery, and Road to Recovery helps us with a lot of the events that we do. Anita Button's in the back. Please raise your hand, Anita. There she is. They really come on board, and there's a nice synergy between what we do and what Road to Recovery is trying to do as well. And so I really appreciate all those people at Road to Recovery and how they help us do what we want to do.
We all want to come back as quick as possible. We all really love what we do, but it's easier to re-injure things and have long-term effects on your injuries if you come back too early. So I know everybody will be itching to get back into their sport and start riding, but you just gotta take the time and do what's right for the body.
What I always felt was best for me was always listen to your body, and I think your body knows when to go. And for me, you know, when I was hurt, I never wanted to ride a dirt bike. You know, I missed it, but my body wasn't going, okay, we gotta go riding. But when my body was like, okay, you know, I'm getting that itch, I want to go riding, I knew it was time.
Thank you for Dr. Augustine and all the things that he's trying to do to help these up-and-coming riders. Bless the people that give their time to make this work. In your great name we pray, amen.
It's a great, great year again. This is my second time to come, and it looks like the thing's growing, and I hope great success to these guys, and glad we could be a part of it, and look forward to continuing to ride my motorcycle and hopefully stay healthy, not need the guys, but it's nice to have them if you do.
It's a great, great organization, and we're glad to be part of it, and we hope that we can continue to do it for many, many years.
We'll see you next year, same place, same time.
Bye.
I just want to thank our riders tonight for being here. I really appreciate it. I thank you all for supporting the foundation. It's really nice to see the support that we have out here. And enjoy your evening, and I hope you have a good time, and see you at the races tomorrow.